At the Pediatric Sleep Center, we take care of children with the full spectrum of sleep problems. It may be issues with children who have problems falling asleep, children who have problems breathing at night, the most common of which is a condition called obstructive sleep apnea. We also care for children with more unusual sleep problems, such as narcolepsy or restless leg syndrome. The amount of sleep that you need really depends on your age. Younger children, you know, stay in infancy, may need 14 to 20 hours for the first couple months of life, then they'll end up sleeping about 14 to 16 hours per day. Older children, once they move through toddlerhood, you're looking at between 12 and 14 hours of sleep in a 24-hour period. In elementary school, that will gradually reduce with time, and a good rule of thumb is that children under 10 in elementary school should get at least 10 hours of sleep at night. In adolescence, most kids will need between 8.5 and 10 hours of sleep a night, though unfortunately not all of them are able to get it because of a combination of their biological drive to stay up later and the fact that their school start times gets earlier and earlier. At Yale Medicine, we tailor our sleep management plan to the child's particular issues. A child with behavioral sleep problems whose parents need guidance on how to manage that will receive very different treatment from, say, a teenager with obstructive sleep apnea. I think the key is that we come up with an individualized treatment plan for each child depending on their age, their development, and their needs. One of the common disorders that we assess in a sleep laboratory is snoring. Now, most children actually should not snore. Some children just snore, though, and other children have a condition called obstructive sleep apnea. And our sleep laboratory lets us differentiate the difference between the two groups. At Yale Medicine, we're fortunate to actually have two pediatric sleep laboratories where we only see children. And we have technical staff that is very experienced in dealing with the needs of children, which is different than the needs of adults who are having sleep testing. Regardless of the child's age, I think parents need to pay very careful attention to electronics in the bedroom. We know that television in children's bedroom are associated with problems as diverse as obesity, insufficient sleep, and problems performing in school. I would advise the parents show that high quality sleep is a priority for them and not just for their children. Our children learn not just by what we say, but what we do. Here at Yale Medicine, the best part of my job is having families come back to see me about 6 weeks after the first appointment and finding that their child's sleeping so much better and that they are as well. I'm Dr. Craig Canapari. I'm the director of the Pediatric Sleep Program at Yale Medicine.